Let us see how sea anemone is attached to the shell lining of hermit crab. This is the sea anemone's body. The complete body of sea anemone is attached on a gastropod shell. The shells are empty, and in these empty shells the hermit crabs live. Now hermit crabs occupy the shells, and on the shells these sea anemones, which are normally sedentary organisms, they get attached. How is the association now? Sea anemone, which is a sedentary animal, that means it won't be able to locomote on its own, it gets to cover a larger area as hermit crab locomotes. The advantage that hermit crab gets is that the complete crab along with the shell gets covered with the sea anemone's body. That means both are getting benefited. But this association is a temporary association. Out of the four options which are given in the question, commensalism, in this one member gets the advantage, and the second member or the second partner is not affected. That means no benefit, no harm. In case of amensalism, one partner definitely gets harmed and there is no effect on the second partner. In case of ectoparasitism, one gets harmed and the second is benefited. That means gets the advantage. In symbiosis, both the partners, they get advantage. Only condition is, in symbiosis, the association has to be permanent. Now, because the association between sea anemone and hermit crab is not permanent, the most appropriate option is commensalism. So, option A, commensalism, is the correct answer.